Okay, so today we're going to sketch the graph of the function y equal e to the minus x squared. So I like to write the function in the form f of x. So f of x is e to the minus x squared. This is an incredibly important function with suitable dilations. It's a normal bell-shaped curve, and we're going to find that out. So first, let's compute the value at 0. F at 0 is going to be e to the minus 0th power, so that's going to be 1. The value of the function at 0 is 1. Let's compute the derivative. F prime of x is going to be minus 2x times e to the minus x squared. Remember, we use the chain rule to compute this derivative. The derivative of minus x squared is minus 2x, and then we have e to the minus x squared. I'm going to need the second derivative, so the second derivative is going to be minus 2 times the derivative of this product. The derivative of x is 1, so we get e to the minus x squared plus x times the derivative of e to the minus x squared, which was minus 2x times e to the minus x squared. So our second derivative of x, it looks a lot worse than the first derivative, and it looks a lot worse than the function, but it's still going to be good. So we get minus 2 times 1 minus 2x squared times e to the minus x squared. Okay, so we have our first derivative, we have our second derivative. Let's find the critical points. So the critical points occur when f prime of x equals 0. When f prime of x is equal to 0, we get 0 is equal to minus 2x times e to the minus x squared. And minus 2 is never 0, and e to the minus x squared is not equal to 0, so x equals 0 is a critical point. The critical value we already know is equal to 1, so we have 0, 1 is a critical point for the function. Now, for inflection points, some people define inflection points to be where the second derivative changes signs. Other people define inflection points to be where the second derivative is equal to 0. In this case, it doesn't matter. Let's set f double prime equal to 0. We get 0 is equal to negative 2 times 1 minus 2x squared times e to the minus x squared. So negative 2 is not 0, e to the minus x squared is not 0, so we must have that 1 minus 2x squared is equal to 0, and that happens when 2x squared is equal to 1, or x squared is equal to 1/2, or x is equal to plus or minus radical 2 over 2, plus or minus 1 over the radical 2. Okay, let's look at the signs of the second derivative, the signs of the first derivative, and then the signs of the function, and when we're finished with that, we'll be able to sketch the graph of the function up here. Okay, so the derivative itself is 0 at 0, and the second derivative is 0 at plus or minus 1 over radical 2. The derivative, remember, was minus 2x e to the minus x squared, and so the derivative is positive to the left and negative to the right, because the derivative was minus 2x to the 2x e to the minus x squared. So in terms of its signs, all we need to worry about is the minus 2x, and that's a negatively sloped line, so it's positive to the left and negative to the right. The second derivative, remember, is minus 2 times 1 minus 2x squared e to the minus x squared. And as far as the signs are concerned, it's a parabola, and it's a happy parabola, because when I multiply through by the minus 2, I'll get 4x squared minus 2. And so it's positive to the outside and negative to the inside. Now we have f is always positive, F is increasing in concave up. It's increasing in concave down, decreasing in concave down, and decreasing. So increasing or decreasing is determined by the sine of the derivative. The concavity is determined by the sine of the second derivative. And we're ready to go. I should also point out that f of x, since it's e to the minus x squared, is always greater than 0. On the other hand, as x approaches infinity, plus or minus infinity, this thing gets really, really small. And so what happens to the function is it's got an inflection point at 1 over the radical 2, another inflection point at minus 1 over the radical 2. Its value at 0 is 1. I think we'll be able to evaluate the function in just a minute. So it changes concavity. There it should be symmetric. And f at 1 over the radical 2 is going to be e to the minus 1 over radical 2 squared, so e to the minus 1 half. So that's going to be 1 over the square root of a. And so that's my value at the inflection point. And that's the sketch of our graph. We've done all we need to do with the critical path.